In this video, let's take a look at new capabilities and enhancements in Simulink to help you edit models at the speed of thought. The first thing you'll notice with 19b is that you now have a toolstrip available to you in Simulink. The goal with the toolstrip is to make it easier for you to access and discover Simulink capabilities when you need them. You see that the tabs are organized by workflow. There's one for simulation, debug, modeling, format, and also one for apps. And Simulink also shows you specific features and menus in the context of the work you're doing. Before the toolstrip, we had functionality buried deep in the menu system, and a lot of that functionality is much easier to find now. So really, that is the value that this brings to you, that Simulink is getting easier to use, and that you can edit your models without the tool getting in the way of your thought process. And if you can find what you're looking for, our documentation gives you a mapping from the menus to the toolstrip to help you out. So effectively, the toolstrip replaces the menu bar as the main menu system in Simulink. And here's a quote from a user who loves how intuitive the tool is. So that is the toolstrip. Now let's look at some enhancements to the editor itself. The first one is that you have the ability to place ports on any side of a block. And this is important because it makes it really simple to create models that are clean and easy to understand. This one is automatic port creation, and it makes it easy to create connections between your model components, instead of having to go into each subsystem in your model to create the ports and then make the connections. You can simply click and drag a block outline to create both a new port and signal. It is also much faster and easier to edit block parameters because you don't have to open the block dialog. You can simply edit the parameter values directly on the block icon. And most likely, you are working with Simulink models that have lots of parameters. We've simplified the process of finding them as you edit your model, and suggestions are provided based on the variables that exist in the workspaces and data dictionaries that the model can access. We're also simplifying the navigation of deep model hierarchies by enabling you to open model references in the same window. You see the new model reference icon in the navigation breadcrumbs? And if you want to look at a model reference in a separate window, that's still possible. You do that by clicking the new icon on the bottom left. And you see that the model reference opens in its own window, and then you also have the breadcrumbs available for navigation. We're speeding up model creation by helping you avoid those cases when you're not sure what the next connection should be in your model. With Predictive Quick Insert, we only show you the blocks that can be connected to an existing port. So in other words, we do the filtering for you. There are also port connection queues that highlight the compatible ports for your next connection. So the software is guiding you as you build your models. And sometimes we forget to load or define variables that a model needs. Now when that happens, you get an instant notification at edit time. And the error queue gives you more information about the missing variable, and it gives you ways to fix the issue. And you will see the same options to fix the issue in the diagnostic viewer. There are also enhancements to smart guides for things like equal spacing, resizing, and aligning elements. And group rotation also got a lot better. And again, the toolstrip exposes a lot of layout and formatting tools that were buried deep in the submenus before. So it's much easier for you to change the format and style of your models to what you need. This one is queues for single and multiple selections. For individual elements like signals, you can easily log and auto-route. And for multiple selections, you can log, group, convert, or comment out those model elements with just a few clicks. So that is an overview of the editor enhancements. You saw that some are helpful for productivity and speed, others help you debug more easily. One of the big ones for debugging is signal tracing. The enhancement here is that you can trace the signals with your keyboard, meaning you can navigate back and forth easily to trace signals to source and destination. And you can also trace signals across model references, subsystems, and other blocks. And when there are multiple possible paths, you can use the down and up arrows to select and follow the path that you want. And that is really useful when debugging your models. If you're debugging your models, it is useful to be able to quickly look at their properties. And the property inspector is a pane in the editor that helps you do that. So you can see and modify properties of model elements like blocks without opening dialogs for those model elements. And you can also see and edit properties for signals as well. Finally, Simulink gives you access to templates and examples for different tasks and applications from the start page. Templates can give you a solid starting point to common modeling approaches. And when you use examples, those can be a valuable reference when you're trying to build your own models. And you can also access your most recent Simulink models and projects right from the start page, as well as the Simulink and Stateful on-ramp tutorials that help you learn Simulink in just a couple of hours. So that brings us to the end of new capabilities for editing models at the speed of thought. See you in the next video.